Andrew Brown was a good person. He was about to get his kids back. He was a good father. Now his kids won't never see him again. They really didn't have to kill him. They didn't have to kill him. It was other things they could use besides killing him.
Well, I just got off the phone, Allison, with the man's family members, and they've identified him as 40-year-old Andrew Brown of Elizabeth City, North Carolina. In fact, I spoke with Andrew Brown's grandmother, who's 92 years old. Lydia Brown tells me that it was just a couple of days ago that he had passed by her house to pick up some mail. She said she wants to know why this happened, what happened, and who was responsible for this. They said they were serving a search warrant and that a sheriff's deputy was involved in this fatal shooting. The State Bureau of Investigation there in North Carolina is now involved in the investigation. You mentioned also government buildings were closed as of about 2.5 hours ago. And details, but here it is again, another black man in America shot and killed in 2021. It's becoming a really unsightly and unfamiliar.
Breaking news right now at 9. A 7-year-old girl is dead tonight after being shot 6 times at a McDonald's drive-thru in Lawndale.
She was in the car with her father, who was also shot. WGN's Megan Dwyer is live at Stroger Hospital with the latest. Megan.
Taman and Jackie, this happened just before 5 o'clock this evening. I am told that this father doesn't get to see his daughter that often today. They had some chance, had a chance to spend some time together, and he took her to McDonald's because that's where she loved eating. Now, police sources tell me tonight this was a targeted gang shooting, and the shooter probably did not see the girl in the car because of tinted windows.
Please put the guns down, please.
The family of 7-year-old Jaslyn Adams, nicknamed Pinky, says she was free-spirited, fun, loved to dance and make videos on TikTok.
It's hard right now.
Today, the Cameron School student was shot 6 times while sitting in a car in a McDonald's drive-thru with her dad in the 3200 block of West Roosevelt. Someone opened fire, riddling the car with bullets.
You got cowards out here killing and shooting babies in Chicago.
Her dad, 28-year-old Jonte Adams, was shot once. He's in stable condition at Stroger Hospital tonight. His mom says he called her right after the incident and said,
I want to give all the praises and the honor to Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shah Bahashim, Recha HaKodash, and double honors to the apostles, the elder apostles, and the elder bishops of Great Millstone. Also, Shalom to you other elders, honors to you elders and you Akim. And let me say Shalom to the followers, okay, to support the truth, and Shalom to the elect. Okay, I wanna go in this video. The brother sent me this screen channel, Ashawn Prince of Power, brother in the camp, shared the video, subscribe to his channel. He goes into these videos, but I said, well, I'll do a video on this. This situation with Andrew Brown and the marching and the Black Lives Matter and everything else. And this is what Christianity has produced, right? I'll say it clearly. Christianity has created this behavior, because then you see Al Sharpton, Jesse Jackson marching for protest and peace, right? Jeremiah 8 and 11 says they have healed the hurt of the daughter slightly, meaning that we don't have the yoke on our neck physically, but peace, but there's still no peace. And this is what they march and say, no justice, no peace. And this is not scriptorial to be marching in your oppressor's territory, asking for forgiveness, or let me say for reparations to be repaired, or asking for justice, when we should be calling out to the name of the Lord. What happens to that? That's when the scripture says they speak with their mouth, but their hearts, their minds is far from the Lord. Romans 13 And let's go to 13 and 13. Right? See what the scripture says. Let us walk honestly as in the day. So this guy, Andrew Brown, he was so sweet and he was such a good man. The dirtiest, grimiest gangbanger is all of a sudden good when they die. And they are good because they go into the spirit world. But notice, the Christian church teaches hell and everybody's going to hell. But when their babies is laying up in the boxes, their children, in those wooden boxes in the church, first thing they say, they're going to be with the Lord. And see, that is an hypocrisy in the Christian church. Because guess where you're going to have the funeral at? They're going to go to the church where that cesspool of dead bodies and dead buried souls, so to speak, that's going up to the spirit world of Satan worship. That's why those churches are satanic. That's where all the dead bodies come running through before they go up to, when the spirit goes up to the spirit world. And they know this. Let us walk honestly in a day, not in rioting and drunkenness, nor in chambering and wantonness, you know, maliciousness, not in strife or in envy. And that's what these guys do. The women, they throwing themselves down and can't breathe. You're going to tell me these cops just pull up on these jakes and just pull out the gun and just blow them away for no reason. Now, let's get it straight. I'm going to both sides of the table. That a lot of these, this situation that we've been set up in coming back from slavery and the upbringing of these young men without fathers under the emotional standard of their mothers who behave like their mothers when they get in these situations where the mother gets off because this is the queen of heaven, but him as a man, you're still, you're still a man. So the police going to look at you as such. So when you want a reason to blow something away, blow somebody away, you create situations. And when these situations are created, then these people act out on it, and now you got a reason to kill them. This is what you see happening. This is what we see happening. They create this. This is a made-up environment. And some of it is fake, in, or we'll say a psyops or whatever you want to call it. But cops are blowing jakes away. Jakes aren't in the mannerism. You got to understand, these men are under PTSD. Jake is not mentally right. So once you make a person not mentally right, then you have the reason to blow them away. And the reason why the argument stands, because, yeah, there's some white people get blown away too, which may have been Jake's. But on the average, the look of that person, if that was a, you know, he had a different look, so to speak, would have been more patience involved. And that's where people are having an argument about. But let's go to Matthew 5 and 25. Agree with thine adversaries quickly while thou art in the way with him, lest at any time the adversary deliver thee to the judge, and the judge deliver thee to the officer, and thou be cast into prison. Right? So this is why it says Hebrew Israelites are so hated. Because aside from the setups of the black Hebrew Israelites coming with knives and machetes, which none of us taught that, and if somebody is behaving like that, that had nothing to do with our doctrine, because there's no Israelite, and I'll say it, one West, that teach to go out with machetes and knives and attack people. But this has been a problem because we have been taking, Jake has been waking up, getting off the street. And I say IUIC, IHPK, we don't agree with their doctrines, but we do agree that they're waking up, people are waking up, they're coming to the truth, and they're finding out that we're Hebrew Israelites and who the enemy is, and this is how you deal with a situation like that. This is how you deal with it. You don't come with knives and try to pull out, you know, weapons. When ultimately this guy Chauvin getting off will be an issue for other cops. So now the other cops got a trigger finger. So let's say it was a psyops. Let's say this whole thing was fake with George Floyd. Let's say it was. Now you've opened up a new door and a new avenue. And this is how these things may or may not get started. Okay? So we know how to, I'll show you how we deal with situations like that. And I'll say it us at Great Millstone, man, how we deal with it when the cops come up to us, right? 1 Samuel 17:45, it says, "Then said David to the Philistine, Thou comest to me with a sword and with a spear and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts and Yahweh of the armies of Israel, whom thou hast defiled." Okay, defied. Okay, so we come in the name of the Lord, Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah. So police pull us over, we walking in the spirit. Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, we, okay, what do you want, officer? Yes, officer, yes, sir. We understand that when you read the scriptures with Isaac and Esau, Isaac blessed Esau with the sword. We understand that. So if he was blessed, okay, meaning conquering, with that sword, what are you supposed to do? But then you're going to have these black nationalists stand up, the Grandmaster Jay or whatever, and all these guys going to stand up and make some crazy fuss about, you know, we sit back and we watch this and we say, okay, we see what's going on. We're not ignorant of Satan's devices. Now, this other guy, and this is what I'm going to go into it also, this Black Lives Matter, the Black Lives Matter, which was funded by George Soros. If you don't know who he is, look him up. This Black Lives Matter, you're marching and you're fighting for Black Lives Matter, but somehow this little girl's life don't matter. This 7-year-old girl that was sitting in the back of seat of a gangbanger's car, of her father's car, who was a gangbanger, he gets shot up, he lives. She gets shot up, she dies. Showing the example of how the Lord works. It's just what it is. So this man say the cowards and shooting up stuff. So where are the marches and the outcries? With Black Lives Matter should be stepping in on this situation. But it seems the little girls' lives and little boys' lives and other lives of so-called black people, it don't really matter. Only thing matter is, hey, we can kill each other. But long as the police don't kill us, that's where we have the problem. Right? So I guess the life only matters when the police steps in and blow you the hell away. This is why the Lord says, what is that? Judgment must begin, okay, in the house of Yahweh. Where is that at? I think it's 1 Peter 4:17 or 18. Let me see. It says, "For the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of Yahweh. And if it first begin at us, what shall it be of them that obey not the gospel of Yahweh?" Right, so we court hell in our everyday lives with our women, families, with our economic situations, you know, bills, and all other kind of stuff that we court. But what is going to be the judgment for Jake that don't believe? Right, we're going to come in the time of Jacob's trouble. We're going to catch hell. We understand that. But this is just the beginning. That's why Matthew 24 says this is the beginning of sorrows. Hosea 4:6, "But my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge." You reject what we say. "I will also reject thee, and thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing thou hast forgotten the law of the Yahweh. I will also forget thy children." Right? "I will forget thy children." And this is what we see happening with the mothers. They're crying out to their sons, and the sons are crying out to their children. I mean, fathers, his daughter shot and killed, and the mothers are suffering. And the reason why the mothers are suffering, because initially taking the bag, taking the hook, line, and sinker of the superior part, so to speak. If you know what I mean. Saying, I'm running this. I'm doing what I want to do. I'm on top. But while you're chasing your careers and you're doing all these things, the foundation for young men that was supposed to be laid out is not there. And then they act like you. And then they go to the cop and was screaming in their face like you would. And guess what's going to happen? They're still men and you're still a woman. So you have a double whammy going on, man. And this is why the Most High is setting his judgment, and this is why a lot of I believe is going to be more of this. And even if some of it is a psyops or fake or whatever, that's going to breed into more things. Remember, all you need is a match to strike a match to start a fire. Okay? That's all you need is a match to strike a fire. So all they need is a reason. That's this lesson. All you're doing is giving them a reason. So now that this stares up, you're going to have other black men, so-called black men, want to be martyrs. Because seeing what happened, and they want to step up, they in hell, so they're going to want to have a reason to get shot too. It's like you Jake's got what you call a death wish. But the Lord has blinded you, and this is an example of Christianity. And if you don't come out of Christianity and have false sense of hope, and a lot of these guys have left Christianity, they left the Bible, but then they left the church, but then now they're gone. They're gone. All of us that came in the truth, we pretty much didn't just jump out of the Christian church and come in the truth. We pretty much left the Christian church. Oh, that ain't for me. I've been falling asleep. They don't teach me nothing. Now they're going into defend the truth and apologias. And now they're saying debate the cause and answer every question. They're learning from us. And now they're going and doing their own biblical theology. And now they're coming back with a new doctrine, trying to captivate the public and bring them back. But once you leave that Christian church and it's been done, nobody goes back to that. So you Christians, you got a losing battle, right? It's all madness. It's all lies, thieves. Nahum 3:1 is woe to the bloody city. It's all lies and robbery. The prey departeth not, man. Okay, that's all I have on that. Shalom.